Hi, Tamika Mosley, everybody, and I have Aiden's paperwork. Okay, so let me briefly and quickly go over everything that happened. So when I got to the office, of course, I let her explain everything, let her get everything out, talk about everything she wanted to talk about. So the first thing that I noticed was his hemoglobin, 7.4. And for me not to have given him anything to help with sickle cell in the past year and a half, for his hemoglobin to be 7.4, that's pretty amazing. Okay, also Aiden's bilirubin levels were a little elevated, and that's why my husband took him in to get blood taken in the first place, because his eyes were a little yellow. And you know the funny thing, he told me that like 3 weeks ago, a month ago, and I said, yeah, I'll just give him some milk thistle. Anyway, so that's elevated, no worries. Milk thistle will take care of that. Right now I'm giving him burdock root. Once I'm out of the burdock root, then I'll get milk thistle and continue to do that. And milk thistle, you guys, are just amazing for repairing the liver, nourishing the liver, detoxing and cleansing the liver, repairing any damage. Milk thistle is amazing. And milk thistle also activates glutathione inside the body, and as we all know, glutathione is the mothership of all antioxidants. His potassium was a little bit elevated, but I really wasn't concerned about that. His retic count was 10, which is extremely high, and she also said that his body is breaking down the red blood cells too fast, or he's producing too many too quickly, too fast. But in the same breath, she looks at my son and she's like, he looks so amazing. He looks great. And clearly there is no sign of him even having a crisis or nowhere near a crisis. So I could kind of tell that she's reading the paperwork, but it's really not lining up with his current state of health. A lot of times, I don't know, it just, doctors are never going to be able to see the power of God's medicine cabinet. Once you take Even Flo, they're not gonna see when that Even Flo meets the sickle cells and how all that happens. After she went over everything on this paper, which it did not alarm me at all, because you know, you guys, I'll tell you why after I tell you this, but I just nicely told her, let me tell you about my son's journey and his history, and just told her how when my son was one, he was hospitalized every 2 months at the hand of doctors, and the entire year he was hospitalized for a crisis. And at the end of the year, his body stopped producing red blood cells and he had to get a blood transfusion. And then a month later, he had to get another blood transfusion. And that's when I had to told her that I had to take my child's life in my own hands. And I started giving him herbs and doing things to help him versus keeping him sicker. And it's been 9 years, no crises, almost 10 years. So she was pretty amazed about his journey. And it's so funny how she still said, but you know, still make an appointment with the hematologist. And I'm thinking to myself, the hematologist cannot tell me anything about my son. Because see, their patients are still having crises, are still going in for pain and pain management and all this stuff. But my son is doing perfectly fine because I'm giving him God's medicine cabinet. And another thing, the doctor's route is hurting the person more than anything. Taking antibiotics every single day, you're killing all the good bacteria in your gut. And that's so dangerous because our gut is connected to almost every system in our entire body. And then cancer medication for life, and you're dealing with all the side effects and damaging the organs, and then narcotics day after day after day. All these things are just toxin after toxin after toxin building up inside the body. And we never think to put anything good to offset all these poisons. No minerals, no herbs, no vitamins, no anything. We know we need to take something to kind of offset these. So I know what I need to do for my son, you know, give him the Even Flo. And you know, a question that was asked to me, why did I stop Even Flo for a year and a half? Well, I read about the study that I talked about 3 years ago, and Aiden has been doing so good when we moved here. Of course, things were so busy and hectic and just moving all over the place. I kind of really just kind of forgot about it because he was just doing so amazing, so great, so well, just playing sports and just not missing a beat. And I, you know, the more I kept not giving it to him, he's just doing better and better. So I just said, okay, let me just try it and see. But as a mother, for me, I want to be on the safe side, and so I am going to start back giving the Even Flo to him. Actually, I have already planned to do that at least 3 or 4 times a week. So that way, I'll know in the back of my head, I can have peace, I can be, you know, be more calm. If I'm giving him the Even Flo, it's going to keep the body naturally producing red blood cells on a consistent basis. So for everybody who's out there taking Even Flo, the advice that I would give from one parent to another parent, I don't know where you're starting from. Like there's been, like see, Aiden never took a bunch of antibiotics. He was never on hydroxyurea. So his body never had the chance to get a lot of toxin exposure to it. And he's been taking herbs since he was 1. It's not to say that you can't heal completely. You may have to just start all over, do a complete detox, and just start from square one. Damage has been done to the body. How much damage have the synthetic drugs done to the body? You know, we have to just consider all these things. But at any rate, thank you guys so much. I'm glad that this worked out. I'm glad that it was not, you know, turned into anything ugly, like trying to turn me in. Because, you know, depending on where you are located in the world, depending on what doctor you get, they will call CPS on you and they're forceful with you and start threatening you. So, Lord knows I do not have time for threats. Not right now. I can't. So, anyway. But thanks so much, you guys, for watching the videos. You know, being with me through this entire journey. I appreciate each and every one of you. And you guys take care. And here's to another 10 years of no crisis.